Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 7.4, Problem 6. This is Section 7.4, Problem Number 6. It says the amount of sodium in the Sharpe's Market Cherise is normally distributed with a mean of 1,351 milligrams per serving and a standard deviation of 123 milligrams per serving. Find the probability that a serving of Cherise has the following amounts of sodium. And there's a part A, part B, part C. So to start the problem, because of the phrase normally distributed, that means I get to use the bell curve and the standard normal chart that goes with it. That's the key, noticing that it says normally distributed. So for the first one, what I need to do is find the z-score for 1,000 milligrams of sodium. I can't look up 1,000 milligrams the way it is, but I can find the z-score for it and look that up. So again, what are we basically doing with this 1,000 milligrams of sodium? The average is 1,351, so it's going to be the middle number. So 1,000 is a little less, and they want the probability of being less than 1,000. So that's visually what we're looking for. So let's convert that 1,000. We'll need the z-score formula. Z equals x minus the mean over the standard deviation. So for this particular problem, the x, the number we want to find the z-score for, is 1,000 minus the mean. The mean is given as 1,351. Over the standard deviation, which is given as 123. So on top, 1,000 minus 1,351 is negative 351. Pay attention to the sign, and you can do it on your calculator. You're going to divide that by 123, so that I really want to use my calculator for. So I will do negative 351 divide by 123, and that's not something I would do easily in my head. So the calculator will do it very easily. And the calculator says the answer is negative 2.8536585537. I don't need that many digits. But that's the z-score. That's what I want to look up in the standard normal chart. So to look up anything in the standard normal chart, what I want to do is first write the number so that it has two places after the decimal. So if I find the decimal, go out two places, I'm at 5. Now the next position over from the 5 is a 3. It's not big enough to make it a 0.86. So it chops at negative 2.85. That's the first step in looking up this number, writing it so that it has two places after the decimal. The next step is to split the number into two parts by pulling off the rightmost digit. So the 5 gets pulled off to the side. After that, we put a 0.0 in front of the rightmost digit that we pulled off. So instead of a 5, it becomes a 0.05. And now what I'm going to do is go to the standard normal chart, look in the negative 2.8 row, make sure you don't miss the negative, the 0.5 column, and see where the negative 2.8 row and the 0.05 column intersect, and they will intersect at 0.0022. So that 0.0022 happens to be the area that's to the left of or less than the 1,000, which is exactly what we want. So the answer to part A is 0.0022. The probability that a serving of Cherise would have less than 1,000 milligrams in the serving is about 0.25%. It's very unlikely. So part B, what's the probability that one serving of Cherise will have more than 1,500 milligrams of sodium? So again, what's going on with this? We have our bell curve. The average value is in the middle, 1,351. Now, 1,500 is a little bigger than 1,351, so it's going to come after or to the right of it. And they want the probability of being more than, that's a greater than. So that's the area that we're looking for, that shaded area that comes after to the right of the 1,500. Now, the chart's going to tell us the blank area, so we'll have to do 1 minus the chart value. So we have to convert the 1500 into a z-score and look it up. So we will use the z-score formula, and I think I'll just make some room so I don't have to write too small. So z equals x, the number to convert into a z-score, this time is 1500, that's the x, minus the mean or average value, if we look, was 1,351. And the standard deviation is given as 123. So now subtract on the top, and you can use the calculator for that. It should be 149, but I will check just to make sure. Positive, so let's clear it. And the top is 149. That I was able to do without the calculator, but the next step of 149 divided by 123, I won't be able to do that. The calculator will do it for me, though. 149 divided by 123 equals, and the calculator says 1.21138214. That's what's on the screen of the calculator. So that's the z-score. That's what I want to look up. So in order to look up 1.21138214, step one is write that number so that it has two places after the decimal. So if I go two places after the decimal, I have a 1. So if I go one more position to the right of that, it's another 1. So it's not big enough to make it a 1.22. It would cut off at 1.21. So that's the first step. I've written the number to look up so that it has two places after the decimal. The next step is to split the number into two parts by pulling off the rightmost digit. Comes 1.2 and 1. The step after that is to put a 0.0 in front of the rightmost digit that you pulled off. And now we can go to the chart. This time we want the positive portion of the chart, so we will go to the 1.2 row, see where that intersects with the 0.01 column, and that will intersect at 0.8869. So now remember, that value from the chart, that 0.8869, is not the answer we're looking for. That's the blank region of my drawing, the less than part that we're not interested. The question asks more than. So I need to do 1 minus the value from the chart for any type of more than question or greater than. So 1 minus 0.8869 would be 0.1131. So that's the answer for part B. The probability of having more than 1500 milligrams of sodium in a single serving of Charisse is about an 11% probability, a little more, almost 11.5%. So now part C, what's the probability that one serving of Charisse would have between 1,000 and 1,500 milligrams of sodium? So again, visually, what would that look like? So we'll have a bell curve. The middle number will be the average, which they give you in the question, 1,351. So between 1,000 and 1,500. And I'll shade that region of my drawing. So ordinarily what you have to do is find the z-score for each endpoint of that interval, look up the z-score in the chart, get two chart values, and subtract the two chart values. But the thing is, we've already done that in parts A and B. The chart value for 1,000 is 0.0022. We already did it. And the chart value for 1500 is 0.8869. Notice that's not the final answer that we got, but that's what would come out of the chart when you look it up. If you convert the 1500 to a z-score, get the 1.21, go to the chart, you'd get 0.8869. And for any in-between problem like this, what you do is get your two chart values and subtract the two. So I will do 0.8869 minus 0.0022. And again, you want to subtract in an order that will give you a positive result. The result is a probability. it must be positive. You can never have negative probability. So that'll be 7488 when I subtract. So the answer to part C is 0.8847, approximately an 88.5% probability that a single serving of cerise would have between 1,000 and 1,500 milligrams of sodium.